parts of the Old Testament to him. And when you come, bring the parchments, bring the papers, brittle and scrolls or whatever, you know. And imagine trying to find a scripture deep in Ezekiel by candlelight in a jail cell with a scroll of paper after scroll after scroll after scroll.
Imagine they didn't have copy machines. They had to recopy it.
Yeah.
They had to rewrite it.
That's true. That's true. Anyway, we have an awesome opportunity to impact this world for Jesus, and we just need some volunteers. Amen. Amen. Chapter 8. Jesus went into the Mount of Olives early in the morning and came again to the temple. And all the people came unto him, and he sat down and taught them. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman to him, taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they said unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery, in the very act. I guess the man run faster because they only caught the woman. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned, but what sayest thou? And this they said, tempting him, that they might have accusation to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, He that is without sin among you, let him cast the first stone at her. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it began, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even to the last. And Jesus was left alone with the woman standing in the midst. And Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman. He said unto her, Woman, where are those thine accusers? Hath no man condemned thee? And she said, No man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, Neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. Classic tale, often to referred to, the woman taken in the very act of adultery. Now, there's been a lot of people who have quizzed about what that Jesus wrote on the ground. What was he writing on the ground? What was he doing? Nobody knows, and it doesn't really matter. If it mattered, they would have included it in the text. Maybe it's for someone to get inspired, you know, later on. Supposing it doesn't matter. But what the pause did, it gave everyone a time to reflect. Everyone began to think about their own situation, you know, and Brother Junior?
I think they were there, was more towards trying to find something against Jesus than it was even about the group.
Because you know that went on all the time.
Yeah.
And without them stoning anybody.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like I said, where was the guy? She was taken in the very act, the guy had to be there. You see? He was just as guilty, except they had a different standard, and so you're right. They just looked for an opportunity to trick Jesus into saying something against Moses. David?
Yes, maybe they were looking to beat him into an argument, and he took the approach of, you know, it's kind of no big deal. You know,
right.
I'm going to ask this question.
Right.
You know, you think about it, you know, whatever.
You know, I think that rather than struggling for an answer in many of the issues that we face with people, maybe if we ask them a question instead and take Jesus' lead and ask them about their own situation rather than about all this posing, it might work. You look at how Jesus, he did this in many circumstances. What does the Bible say about it?
Yeah.
That's a good one. You know, I don't think there's anything wrong with drinking. Well, what does the Bible say about it? You know what I mean?
He drinks and be merry.
Yeah. you see, this is, you know, it, rather than jumping on somebody and saying, you know,
making it contentious.
Jesus took a different way of dealing with things. We like to deal with it head on, don't we? I mean, we just like to hit them hard and Jesus had a way. Jesus had a way of doing this, and you can see it multiple times when they ask about John the Baptist, when they ask about him. He said, "Well, was the baptism of John the Baptist, was it of men or was it of God?" And they were afraid to answer because they knew that either way they went was wrong, you know, because they was going to enter some trouble. The same thing about the issue of them asking, "By what authority do you do this?" And he said, "Well, by what authority do you do the things that you do?"
The Sabbath.
He had a way. He had a way of doing things. And you know what? If the very Spirit of God that was in Christ Jesus and rose him up from the grave, if that dwells inside of us, then we have wisdom that we haven't tapped into yet. Or maybe we have, and maybe you are good at winning people to the Lord or presenting the argument, but let me tell you something. It's not a big struggle. It's not a, you need to take multiple witnessing classes. You know, maybe you need to begin to know who you have a relationship with, because he will shine through you if you allow him to. How will he do that? In your kindness, in your meekness, in your gentleness, in your temperance, in your love, in your hope, in your faith. He will shine through you by you demonstrating why he came. Anyway, it's a good situation because oftentimes we're presented with the Old Testament versus the New Testament. There's a lot of people, and I'll go a little deeper here, there's a lot of people who don't know what to leave in the Old Testament. You see what I'm saying? And well, you know, according to the Bible, it's an eye for an eye. You know, what was it? Next of kin? They read that scripture in that they was going to kill somebody that killed somebody that killed their brother. They was going to kill them and say, well, the Bible says an eye for an eye. You see? And listen, you can see people in a church that's separated from and looking in the Old Testament. Right here it says an eye for an eye. Let's go get him. You know what I mean? And you can see people operating in that kind of mentality because they have no idea who Jesus really is and what happened when he came. Because we know that there are things that we don't do that are still contained in the Old Testament, but there are a lot of things that were Mosaic laws and customs that we're no longer bound by. If Jesus was a strict student of the law, those people were right, according to the letter. She was supposed to be stoned, but so were disobedient children. Ooh, we'd be freed up then, wouldn't we, Junior? Think about it. But the age of mercy and grace